Here's a little something that I'm going to throw out into the world, a little idea or thought or observation. This colony has got a huge amount of crazy cracks throughout all these supers, and they're all over the place. And I don't know if you can see it. Hey, yeah, you can see it. Cool. That's nothing but propolis. These bees have sealed in every single crack. And I have another colony that's gone heavy duty on the propolis too. And they are clustered way at the bottom of the hive. And this here hive that's out in the middle of nowhere, out in the wind and on the edge of a field, is also clustered at the bottom of the hive. I looked up top, I can hear them buzzing, which is really cool. But I looked up the top, I pulled the top off, and I'll just show you. Let's see if we can do this. That's it, no bees. So they're not clustering up top. They're still pretty far down below. They're so far down below that I can't see them clustering. My observation is that the only other colony that I have where the bees are really clustered down below is the other one that has propolized everything. All the other ones, they're kind of propolized a bit, but this one, and then the other one that are big on the propolis are clustering down below. And clustering down below, in my book, is always a good thing in the middle of the winter, because they just slowly work their way up. And last winter, all of my colonies were like that. They were all, I worked them in a way so that most of them stayed clustered down below all winter long. And then they slowly, some of them didn't go to the top until April, which was fantastic. And I've never seen my bees come out of the winter so full of life and so well. And I think a part of it had to do with the fact that I got them to cluster down below, and they had all that honey and insulation up top, and it was great. Because sometimes when they're not clustered down below, they'll stay up top, and then you end up giving them sugar, and then come spring, you look inside, and there's still honey down below. Like, they don't eat all their honey. And then you're dealing with sugar, and it's fine, you know, whatever. But if I don't have to deal with sugar, then great. And I think I've got it. I think there's two things happening here. One is, these bees, and they're so defensive too, which is great. That's exactly what you want to see in the winter time. You don't want them to be chilled out entertainers in the middle of the winter. You want them to be ready to go, ready to just come and get you at the least disturbance. They're protecting their queen. They're trying to stay clustered. They're trying to stay warm. They're very protective, which is fine in the winter time, right? Anyway, there's a trick I've sort of figured out a way to get them to cluster down below. Anyway, cluster down below, and bees that are highly into propolis, maybe they're the kind that will naturally seal off the hive in a way that they want to cluster down below, which is what you want in the wintertime. So I might keep a note of this colony and my other one, which are big on the propolis, and in two different, completely different locations, but behaving the same way. I might want to breed these queens, because if they have this tendency to propolize, seal off the hive in the winter, and cluster down below, that's great. Anyway, that's my big thought for today. Okay, so I'm experimenting with bubble wrap today, and the question is, do I put the flat part of the bubble wrap on the outside or the inside? I think I'm going to put it on the inside, because then it'll create, even the spaces in between the bubbles will create a little bit of insulation as well. But see, then it also might just keep in, yeah, screw it. See, it's hard to say, I don't know, because see, you could, if I put it that way, if I put the bubbles on the inside, it might also trap moisture inside. Ah, screw it. Let's do it with bubbles on the inside. Okay, so I just wrapped this hive around twice with some bubble wrap. I might staple it on a bit tighter in a few spots. So that's the trick about all of this. You got to get it tight. As tight to it as you can get, right? So I'm just going to staple this down and see. I don't know how well this is going to work, but we'll see. Maybe it'll create a greenhouse effect and keep the hive warm, because underneath this is black, right? So the sun gets in there, the black heats it up, and the bubble wrap keeps the heat intact. We'll see. I don't know. Could be a good idea, could be a bad idea. But I got this wrap. I think it was 50 feet, 2 feet wide, for $24 Canadian. I'll just staple it up, make it a little bit tighter, and I've got an entrance right here. I got to cut a hole in the entrance. I'll just make sure that the bottom entrance is clear, but it is actually pretty clear. I think you should be able to get out of there. I might staple that bit down a bit, just keep it open right there. Anyway, we'll see. Hopefully it'll work. And I'm glad that the staple gun didn't disrupt the bees or disturb the bees too much so that they're pouring out of the hive. I hate that when that happens. So they must be pretty cold in there, not to even want to break cluster from the rack into that thing. So, okay, so there we go. The entrance, I got an entrance drilled into the super right here. And there's sort of one up here, but then just ignore that. Yeah, so there it is. I cut the hole through the plastic, the wrap, and I just taped in the hole with a bit of duct tape, and hopefully that won't be a mess and that duct tape will stick. Or it's a month from now that it'll all be peeling out all over the place, and then, you know, water will be pouring into the hive and all kinds of fun stuff, but we'll see. This is the thing I don't like about my experience so far with any kind of wrap, is that, especially in Newfoundland, the rain just starts pouring down, it gets inside the wrap, the wraps get all moldy, they hold the mold inside, it gets all moldy and gunky and keeps actually the hive wet. I think there are some types of wraps that can prevent that, but I haven't found it yet. Alright, there's the wrap blowing away. It's cold and windy out here, it always is. This is why I love having the hives next to my house, surrounded by trees in a nice sheltered spot. Anyway, I had some corks in that super, and on the other side of that super, I don't know why I've got them on both sides, can't remember. Anyway, I had to trim the edges off them so that I can get the plastic over it. So now I'm gonna take that plastic, wrap it around, staple it on, put my ratchet strap back on. Again, this is a ratchet strap that goes click, 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 click when you tighten it, and it riles up the bees. Whereas if these little sports straps and my bleeding fingers, the sports strap don't do that. You just pull it and it tightens, and it works just as well as a ratchet strap. So I'm switching to sports straps from now on. Anyway, everything's blowing away. Let's go. Now these bees are coming out. They're pouring out of the hive entrance. So I'm going to put a bit of duct tape over that hole for now, just to keep them in there while I've got the, while I'm, you know, banging on the hive with the staple. Okay, so, man, it's cold. We've got a blizzard coming, today's Wednesday, so we got a blizzard coming on Thursday afternoon, going into Friday, 30 centimeters, which is about as deep as my boot, and, yeah, so there we go, there it is. I ran out of staples in my staple gun, so I had to just duct tape it all together. Who knows if this duct tape is going to hold it together or if it's going to work. We'll see. But anyway, these bees are definitely in a bad mood. They were pouring out of the hive entrance, the top entrance right there. And I taped it up, I duct taped it up just to get them out of my face while I was doing this. I've got this thing on. I use the ratchet strap, but boy, it goes click, click, click. Like, I'll show you. Just like, hold on. That. All right, that is just, hold on. You go like this. So it's already tight, but, you know, the clicking of that, it just vibrates right through this thing, and it's, they don't like it. They don't respond well to vibrations. Most times a year, especially in the middle of the winter when they're just, you know, struggling to stay warm and stay alive and protect their queen. Anyway, ran out of staples, and so I only wrapped the hive down to equivalent of, it's probably, this one is wrapped. This is 2 feet high, and that's three deeps, or three mediums, so that's the equivalent of about two deeps. So that's what this is too. And just before the fall or the winter kicked in, I dropped this extra medium on top of it because I had some extra honey, so I just gave them that. And so there's the entrance right there, and there's one down there, and that's pretty good. But man, is it ever windy. But anyway, those bees are alive for now, and they're definitely good. Or at least they seem good. They're not running out of food. They're way down below. I hear them buzzing, so no worries. I'm not even going to think about them. These guys are up top, though. I don't know why they're up top. When I did see them coming up, through the undercover hole, I could see that there was uncapped honey. So they're not totally starving yet. I don't think they're starving at all. But anyway, whatever. So I don't know if this duct tape is going to hold or what's going to. It's just going to be make a big mess. We'll find out. Oh, they've got no insulation. It's just an undercover with a ventilation rim, or in this case, a ventilation box up top. This is sort of the DE hive configuration for that. I'm going to pull that tape off, and hopefully the bees won't be, you know, it's been a few minutes since I was stapling and banging around with the outside of the hive and tapping on that thing. So hopefully when I pull this off, the bees won't even try to come out. And the thing is, even earlier when they did try to come out, they they just got hit by this cold wind, and they said, oh, the hell this, and they went right back in. So they're not on a suicide mission yet. They're not that angry, so which is smart. Sometimes they get so angry. I don't know how I cut my finger. Sometimes they're so angry that they are so defensive that they'll just come right out even if it's freezing, and they'll just instantly die in the cold. So let's see what happens. Anyway, I'm going to pull this off, and then I'm running to my car and call it done. Oh, good, they're done. They're not in there. There you go. Okay, I'm out. So yeah, look, those are unhappy defensive bees. And you can see they're getting hit by that cold, and they're going, okay, I want to be defensive, but I don't want to go in that cold. And now they're going back in. Let's see how close I can get to them. Hopefully this isn't a disaster. Hopefully I haven't done more harm than good. Most of the things that are detrimental to a honeybee colony living inside a hive are the things that a beekeeper does. So it's often better just to do nothing. And I think I'm not convinced that this wrap or any kind of wrap is necessary now. I've got these hives painted black. It gets cold. We do get some wind chills of, you know, minus 20 degrees Celsius once in a while, but not persistently. I don't know, I'm not convinced that coddling the bees, wrapping them and putting them in bee cozies and all this other junk is actually doing them any favors. It's not, you're not exactly creating survivor stock then, right? By keeping them, you know, cold and giving them a brutal winter to survive through, and seeing how they come through in the spring, you're gonna know which ones are strong, right? Some of them will die, some will come out weak, and the strong ones though, boom, those are the ones you want to breed. So that's the approach that I'm taking, because I hate wrapping. I hate all this winter crap. So anyway, we'll see.